Solve the system by elimination. 4x plus 3y equals 10, and negative 9x plus 4y equals negative 1. The process for solving a system of equations by elimination is to add the equations so that you get a variable to cancel out. So I'm just going to write a little note there, add equations, and that will eliminate, if done correctly, it will eliminate a variable. And then we'll go from there. Okay, if we were to add these equations, we would get 4x plus negative 9x is negative 5x, and 3y and 4y is 7y. That would not eliminate a variable. So what we're looking for is a way to make these equations such that we have opposite coefficients. That is, one is positive and one is negative. Opposite coefficients. Well, we can do that with either the coefficients on the x variable or the coefficients on the y variable. I'm going to choose the y variable in this case, just because I can see that that'll be a lower number coefficient that we would have to get to. So you may have to multiply. Sometimes they're all set up. This one is already set up. The x plus y equals some constant. And that's, you want them to both be set up in that order so that you can add straight down. And some of them are already set up so that you can just add and the variables will just, one of the variables will drop out. But this one is not set up like that. So opposite coefficients, let me just put right here. One is positive and one is negative. Well, we've got a positive and a negative here, but that's going to give a really high coefficient if we try to multiply both of these, not with each other, but we multiply something by this equation and multiply something by the second equation. Now, it's similar to finding the lowest common denominator. That is, what is common among 3 and 4? If we were to list the multiples of 3, 3, 9, 12, 12, 4, 8, 12, 12. So it looks like let's make something common here with the 3 and the 4. But we want them to be opposite. So I want to build this 3 up to 12. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to multiply this whole equation by 4. So that 4 times 3 is 12. I am also going to multiply the other equation. You won't always have to do this on a system of equations, but this one is specifically set up so that you do have to, and so you get to see everything that's going on here. We're going to multiply this by 3 to get to 12. 3 times 4 is 12. But we want the opposite coefficients. So I'm going to multiply everything by negative 3. So negative 3 times positive 4 is negative 12. Okay, let's write the results then. And I'm just going to draw some quick lines down here so you see where we're going with this. The first equation, 4 times 4x is 16x. 4 times 3y is 12y, and 4 times 10, let me just draw a line here of what I'm doing here, 4 times 10 is 40. That's the first equation. The second equation, negative 3 times negative 9 is positive 27, and that's multiplied by x. Negative 3 times positive 4 is the negative 12y that we were looking for. That's good. When we add these will drop out. And negative 3 times negative 1 is positive 3. All right, let's add those. Add the equations, eliminate a variable. 16x and 27x is 43x. 12y and negative 12y is 0 equals 40 times 3 is 43. Excellent. Divide by the coefficient and we get x equals 1. That is one of the values. That's half of the solution, right? We need an x value and a y value. The next step, just like with solving by substitution, is to take this value that you found and plug it into in for y into one of these equations. I'm going to choose the first equation just because there's not a negative there, and you know, the negative is fine, but maybe it might be a little bit less messy. So let's just do that. I'm going to plug in, let's see what color. I'm going to use blue. I'm going to plug in 1 wherever I see x. So I have 4 times the 1 plus 3y equals 10. And I specifically left that so that I could put the 1 in red just to signify that I'm doing that x value. All right, let's finish this. 4 plus 3y equals 10. 3y equals 6. I've got to come up here. And y equals 2. So that's the process. We added the equations. We had to manipulate the equations a little bit, but then add the equations so that we get a variable to drop out. Now we have an equation in one variable. Solve it. Take that value, plug it into one of the original equations, solve for the other variable. And then in the end, we have our final answer. 1 is the x value and 2 is the y value. So that is solving a system of equations by elimination.